I greet Your Excellency Most Reverend Andrews Tzat, Metropolitan Archbishop of Trcyur, and all your participants to the 13th International Symposium organized by Mary Mata Major Seminary. I thank you for the invitation, even though from a distance, to this important event aimed at preparing better the future priests in response to the challenges of today's world, and at allowing discussions among experts in theology on important issues emerging from intercultural and interreligious context that characterize the globalized society. The proposed theme of the symposium, The Synod Way of Being the Church, Prospects and Challenges, is rich in implication that will certainly be identified and proposed by experts who also know how to incarnate in the historical and cultural context of India common ideas to general reflection. Having the privilege to participate at the last synods of the bishops held in Rome, I can only be pleased with your choice that captures the novelty of the Church's journey in our times, under the guidance of the recent popes, especially under the magisterium of Pope Francis. Journeying together, in fact, is not other than feeling of being people of God, gathered in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, in order to be witnesses to the love of God, who desires all humanity to be saved. Before anything else, albeit a necessary distinction, the Church is the people of God, who through baptism forms part of a kingdom which Christ inaugurated on the earth through his passion, death, and resurrection. Through baptism, all believers are called and are sent to proclaim the gospel and to give a witness to it in charity. We can recall that the Second Vatican Council affirms in Lumen Gentium, number 12, that the Holy Spirit sanctifies and leads the people of God and enriches it with virtues, but allotting his gift to everyone according as he wills. He distributes special graces among the faithful of every rank. By these gifts, he makes them fit and ready to undertake the various tasks and offices which contribute toward the renewal and building up the Church. Synodality, therefore, signifies knowing how to value all the gift that the Holy Spirit distributes in the Church through dialogue, which does not eliminate the diversity of gifts and ministries, but harmonizes in order to favor everyone's growth in docility to our one and only Shepherd, who is Christ the Lord. This applies to the universal Church as well as to the particular churches in which the mission of the Church is embodied. Living in the time of globalization, such task of the Church is especially important in order to avoid the diversity sacrificed in the name of conformism to a culture in which those who have more power dominate. In this regard, I hold it important for the local churches to reflect on their role in the enculturation of the faith in their countries, without breaking from communion with the Universal Church under the guidance of the Roman Pontiff. In a special way, your glorious nation, with its traditions and diversity, can give the Universal Church a precious contribution by enriching the gifts of the Holy Spirit to your people. The recent renewal of affiliation of the academic activities of the seminary to the Faculty of Theology of Loewen is an additional element in bringing about this communion in the Church pointed out by Pope Francis in the Apostolic Constitution Veritatis Gaudium, when he invited all our ecclesiastical higher educational institutions to promote networking, not only in order to raise their quality and standard, but moreover in order to express, I quote, the very Catholicity that makes the Church a living of unity in diversity and communion in freedom. With these words, I express my best wishes for the complete success of this symposium, both in the active participation of those present, as well as in the deepening of the chosen team. The symposium itself, in fact, is an example of synodality, and therefore of the Church present in India and in your region. Rest assured of my blessing and encouragement, and that of the Congregation for Catholic Education. Thank you very much. Tanti auguri.